Thank you for tuning in at the Auto Expo 2020. Clearly, the bus is here at India Expo Center. We are at the BYD stall, and behind me you see these beautiful electric buses, starting with the K6, followed by the K9 and the K12. Now, BYD has been aggressively establishing its presence in the Indian markets in the last couple of years, as you may have read about it in our magazines. The buses are doing very well in various STUs, be it from in Maharashtra or right across to even higher altitudes as far as Himachal. So the buses have proven their mettle, and the company, with its aggressive bidding and a very, very tactical strategy, is giving the home manufacturers a run for its money. So we'll be interacting shortly with the MD of BYD here in India after the Olectra BYD partnership and get you more details. So stay tuned and watch out for that special interaction. We have with us Mr. Naga Satyam. He's the Executive Director of Olectra Greentech Ltd. Sir, first up, you know, this whole rebranding bit, there's a lot of confusion around the BYD brand. You started as BYD, then there was a Goldstone badge, and now then you had to make over the entire image as an imagery makeover with the green initiatives you all decided upon Olectra. So where does that equation stand now?
Okay, let me just, you know, clear the first thing. First, yeah. Like, you know, since the beginning, it is like Goldstone BYD. These two different entities actually.
Right.
We came together and we started manufacturing these buses and supplying these buses in India actually.
Right.
Okay, and Goldstone Infratech, we just renamed it from Goldstone to Olectra Greentech.
Okay.
So technically speaking,
it's
nothing changed. It's still the same thing.
Okay.
Earlier it is used to call as Goldstone BYD. Now we are calling it as Olectra BYD.
Right, but I was also told that it was a very conscious decision to, you know, venture into that green branding space, because obviously the bus is green after all.
Yes, actually it is one of the primary reasons. Earlier it is known as Goldstone Infratech Limited.
Yeah.
But actually we were into infrastructure related business earlier. We were manufacturing polymer insulators actually.
Okay, okay.
So in fact we thought like it's apt to have this Olectra Greentech Limited. Yes, it's a, you can say that, you know, we are just rebranding the entire thing, reinventing ourselves, and we are just, you know, moving towards a automobile sector actually.
Right. So taking from that particular bit before I come on to the bus, where did you see the green shoots in the automotive sector? Because at a time when you came in, that time the industry was sort of buzzing, but now the situation is in complete contrast. So do you feel your plans have gone awry over there, or are you looking at this as a major opportunity?
See, actually what I say, you say like, you know, there was a buzzing. When we entered, there was no buzz actually, honestly speaking.
Yeah, from the e-mobility perspective, it was not there.
Absolutely,
yes.
Zero. When we entered in 2015, people totally unheard of what is an electric bus. People even doubted that, like, you know, oh, electric bus, Satme, you have a diesel engine also.
Okay.
We used to explain them that's an hybrid model. No, it's a pure electric. People had doubts also.
Right.
And we demonstrated our capability in Manali Rohtang Pass.
Right.
Manali Rohtang Pass is a very difficult terrain for any mobility.
Right.
And electric mobility particularly, it has got its own challenges, because the battery, the capacity, the chemistry of the battery behaves very differently.
Yeah.
When it moves an altitude of 13,500 feet,
right,
actually.
Right.
We had our own, you know, we never tried that actually. And we tried it in Manali Rohtang Pass, who successfully showcased it to Himachal Road Transport,
yes,
actually. And they were very elated with the response, like, you know, with one single charge our bus, it's a 110 kilometer stretch actually.
Right.
There is no provision to charge the bus in Rohtang Pass actually.
Right.
So we have to go, the bus has to go, it's a, sometimes the gradients are so steep actually. So the bus went up, came down successfully, and the total SOC consumed is only 48%.
Right.
So that gave us a lot of confidence actually.
Right.
So, and even for BYD also, it is for the first time in the world for them also to have this kind of a experience actually.
Right.
So from there actually, you know, we gained strength, and you know, we deployed 6 buses in Best Mumbai, and 40 electric buses in Hyderabad. For the first time in the country, we deployed 12 meter low floor AC electric buses,
right,
in Hyderabad.
Right.
And 2019 is a biggest turning point for us. We deployed 150 electric buses in Pune city.
Okay.
If you go to Pune city, you will see 150 buses of ours. And it's very happy for us to see that people are just waiting for us, you know, to board our buses actually.
Right.
They skip the IC buses.
Mm-hmm. So that trend has particularly caught up with BST, it has caught up with NMMT, it has caught up with the Himachal Road Transport. You're looking at other regions, even I think DTC also, there was a news. So which is the latest milestone STU order for the company, you know, from pilot to actually the end transaction?
See, actually fortunately, thanks to FAME 1, and there's a huge interest in STUs to have these electric bus actually. These buses were no more aspirational actually. People understood that yes, these buses, they can deploy them actually. Because earlier they think like, you know, these buses are aspirational, you know, okay, it is okay to have one or two buses. But with this FAME 2 scheme where they offered like, you know, the electric buses on gross cost contract. So people suddenly thought, oh, we can even take the buses on lease. Suddenly that opened up, you know, complete the business doors for all the OEMs.
Are you wary as an OE that it is a leasing model at the end of the day and not a purchase model where you would ideally like people to buy the bus?
No, actually, I suggest actually to them how it can lease actually.
Okay.
Because this is a new technology and STUs, you know, they should go in a gradual phase, like, you know, experimentation. If you acquire the bus actually, if it doesn't run tomorrow, then the entire thing, you know, the entire electric mobility industry will be blamed actually. So once you practically sell actually, most of the OEMs, they take responsibility.
Would it be right to say that this is like an extended pilot for the bus?
Actually, it's not an extended pilot. I say that it's going to be it's going to stay here, and this is going to be the business model at least for the next 5 years, I can say.
Okay. What about the battery cost? We hear that there is some change over there with lead costs coming down, the battery costs slightly showing a reversal of trends. So do you feel you've been able to near to your target of economies of scale?
No, I have a very different take. People are talking like, you know, battery prices are falling down very drastically.
Not drastically, yeah. Okay. Maybe I think there's an 8% stat over a few years.
Okay, glad at least you said only 8%. But I hear people are talking, you know, people are quoting, I use the word crazy. Crazy prices actually for batteries actually. See, everywhere if you reduce the price, you have to cut some corners actually.
Sure.
But whereas in our model actually, this bus for the next 12 years, 10 to 12 years, I have to run for an STU. So I can't cut the corner. So I have to have the best battery available actually. So the best thing comes with the best price only. It's you don't get, you know, the price and the quality.
But you have an edge because you have a battery lineage also.
Yes.
So how does that benefit you compared to competition clearly?
No. Actually, see, that we have an advantage in terms of quality. We have an advantage in terms of, you know, better battery management system.
Thermal management, how evolved is it now for the e-buses since the time you started? Because you would have now with different STUs, applied your buses from extreme hot temperatures to maybe even the slightly higher altitudes, the cooler temperatures. How do you feel the thermal management plays havoc in different scenarios, or has it been stable as per expectations?
See, earlier these buses were only air-cooled buses, but gradually from air-cooled to now they are oil-cooled actually.
Okay.
So we are adding as and when it is required as per the weather conditions, as per the requirement actually. So, you know, this is not required in all the places actually. Himachal might require a different kind of a thermal management system. Rajasthan might require a different management system. South India, which is slightly hotter, that requires a different management system. So what I'm trying to say, it depends, but overall, like our thermal management system is like from air cool to we move to oil cool.
Let's come to the buses at Auto Expo. K6, again, the K6 e-bus, and then you have the K9, and then about to launch the C9. So how is this hierarchy with K6, K7, K9, and then where does C9 come in?
Actually, there is one more bus which we have not displayed because that's widely, because most of them are, that is called K7. That's a 9-meter bus.
K7 is the one that you've given to BST.
BST, yeah. And Pune and, you know, to Manali, Rohtang Pass, like, you know, we have those, that series more, we have more of that series now. So this C9 is basically an intercity coach. See, it's a long distance intercity coach. With one single charge, it can run up to 350 kilometers. And I don't think so anyone in the country as of now is having this the capability to run for a longer
No worries. Are you also sensing a competition from other fuel sources, like till few years back CNG as a long range was not imagined? Now you have those type 4 composite cylinders coming in, and suddenly, you know, the whole range of alternate fuel sources now competing for a longer range. Something like a CNG, a type 4 composite cylinder was tested recently, 1000 kilometer range. When you say that your C9 has a range that is first in the segment, how do you compete with, you know, something like composite cylinders coming in and promising a range?
See, actually anything, like for an operator, for anyone, basically they look for two factors. One is the kind of an operations and maintenance, and the second thing is the running cost. See, when someone can offer a better like, you know, these two things, like, you know, together. Like we have a better running cost with electric. Any electric mobility has got a better running cost than CNG or traditional fuel.
Sure.
Similarly, you are aware that, you know, very few moving parts are in this any electric mobility.
So, where in there is automatically.
So, obviously, these two factors are combined. And third thing, there are almost close to, in India, for every 100 people, we have only 10 buses actually.
Right, right.
So, there's a huge requirement is there. Okay, that means, you know, I don't see there's any competition actually. I tell you, in India, the industry is just emerging actually.
Right.
There's
right.
a huge opportunity. So, there are plenty of opportunity for many people. The cake is so big, you can't even imagine actually.
You mentioned about the gross contract value coming into the FAME 2 scheme. Do you, as an OE, wish that model to be extended to the private bus fleets? You know, that opens twice the number of doors for you rather than just looking at STOs.
No, that is true. In fact, that was happening already. See, like two state transport undertaking, like, you know, Rajasthan state transport undertaking, they already in under FAME 2, they extended this to for intercity coaches also actually.
Okay.
And at the same time, this Northwest Karnataka, there's a body called Northwest Karnataka State Road Transport Corporation. They have already tendered for 50 buses actually.
Okay.
So this is already happening already.
Okay.
And similarly, Andhra Pradesh government also, under FAME 2, Government of India has given some, given permission to procure some buses, which they are yet to come out with a tender actually.
Right.
So it is already happening. It is already getting extended.
Right. Would you be happy to commend your team with the way actually they are pursuing these STU tenders? Because somewhere the homegrown manufacturers are not able to compete as good as you, because you seem to be landing up with a lot of right STU orders and you have your buses plying on the road. The response has been good. What exactly is going for you?
So here, unfortunately, this is the most unfortunate fact, the kind of people are spreading false rumors about us. I bet and I challenge no other manufacturer in the country has spent as much as we have spent on this establishing the manufacturing.
You look at it as an ROI for you?
No. As a manufacturer, I have spent almost close to 600 crores.
Okay.
Purely for electric bus manufacturers. Show me one other manufacturer who has spent this much money.
Right. So
then who is more indigenous here?
Right.
And second thing is the rumors are, they spread the rumors in such a way that, you know, see, even currently, even the IC engine diesel buses, you know, what is the procurement level, indigenous level of, you know, that 70%.
Localization, yeah.
70%. Even after 5 decades.
Yes, yes.
And now we are doing 40% already just within 4 years.
Right.
Okay. And see, when you can't stomach somebody's success, see, you need to have a technology actually. If you don't have the technology, don't start blaming. No, I am an Indian company. It's listed in the Indian stock exchange.
Yeah.
It's for 2 decades actually. I got some technology from outside and I'm deploying the buses here. And, you know, these kind of false rumors are being spread actually.
We are very, very glad to have spoken to you and have you cleared the air up front. On the product here, what is the USP of this bus that we see over here, a new addition to your lineup? And I know you would like to wait a little time before you unleash the details on the C9.
The USP is like zero emission.
Right.
Zero emission.
Right.
Zero emission.
Okay.
That's see, people are not costing the public health in when they are doing the financial modeling. Actually.
Right.
It has got a huge impact, huge cost.
Right.
You have to figure in that actually.
Right.
See, if my bus runs 350 kilometers, that means I'm going to save close to reduce the emissions by 200 kilograms on each ride actually.
Right.
That's going to have a huge impact. Mm. See, unfortunately, we see everything vis-a-vis how much running costs.
Mm.
But these costs, intangible which are not benefit. Indirect costs, intangible benefits, see, you have to take them into consideration actually.
Would you wish that India goes the renewable energy source way also? Because on one hand, as an OE, you are ensuring to adopt the best green practices, but the source of generation is not low on carbon footprint. So I think with other countries there is a renewable source of energy model. You think that India needs to take drastic steps to ensure that kind of a model in place?
Actually, by 2030 India is going to have the renewable if recently in the recent budget also
there's an allocation
actually. They said any thermal power plants which are not meeting the criteria, Government of India is asking them to shut it down actually.
Right.
So that clearly shows the which direction we are going.
Right.
This electric mobility, this transport segment, and they're taking care of the thermal sector. You know, it's going to be a huge change actually. By 2030, we are going to have much more cleaner air, at least, you know, I can
Right. So you have that early mover advantage with you. Your perspective on the control on the import and export of certain commodities that the government has taken in the interest of local manufacturers. Now, since you have a high level of localization, are you for that kind of a control with the government?
In fact, I'm very happy. Reason is some people are straight away importing the completely built unit CKDs, and they're doing some, a kind of a assembly and doing it actually.
Right.
So, but whereas we are spending almost, we have huge employees like working, we are doing it. So we welcome that stuff, and it's the right step actually towards Make in India.
Right. Going forward, your growth and challenge areas.
See, our growth, we are expecting our coach is going to add huge revenues to us actually.
Right.
Because this private business is going to stay here for a long. And second thing, as I rightly pointed out, in the next 5 years, almost we are going to have 100,000 electric buses on roads, not ours actually. I'm talking about the industry.
Totally. Yeah.
So if you take even a 20% out of it, actually, it's going to be a huge phenomenal revenue.
Right.
So from in 2019, we sold 235 electric bus. This year, we are going to have 735. So in the next 5 years, actually, we are talking at least 20,000 electric buses on the roads.
20,000 electric buses on the road. Congratulations
next 5 years.
To you on that vision, and all the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much.